Good morning. Today I would like to discuss about how appeals are being disposed. What is appeal? How to pursue the appeal? And what all are the directions for the appellate court to dispose the appeal? AR 2020 Supreme Court 925 Mallaru Mallappa versus Karu Vattappa and others. In this case, CPC 96 Order 41 Rule 31 was deeply discussed along with specific relief act section 16C. The Supreme Court has said shortly that appeal is a continuation of proceedings of the original court. The appellate jurisdiction involves rehearing on law as well as on fact and is invoked by an aggrieved person. They say all questions of fact and law decided by trial court are open for reconsideration. Therefore, the appellate court is required to address itself to its finding after dealing with all issues of law, facts and evidence, oral as well as documents. In the given case, the appellate court did not comply the requirement of Order 41, Rule 31, which mandates that the court must follow it while deciding the appeal. The High Court order was set aside, stamping it as a critique order. Several Supreme Court judgments, AR 2015-12-10, 2001, 1980, 70, 63, were deeply discussed. Kindly go through the entirety of judgment so that you can understand how the appeal to be discussed. The Black Law Dictionary appeal was also discussed, wherein it was stated the proceedings undertaken to have decision reconsidered by bringing it to a higher authority was the definition of Black Law Dictionary. Then they have also discussed about United Nations Constitution Article 1762, what was the appellate jurisdiction. They say writ of error or by an appeal by some process of removal of a suit from an inferior tribunal. This is the process of civil law origin. Then they finally discussed Order 41, Rule 31, which mandates the appellate court to determine the decision thereon, reasons for the decision, where the decree is appealed from reversed or revaried, relief to which appellant is entitled. These all are the things to be considered while deciding the appeal. Finally, they say that this section 54 of the Limitation Act was one of the major pleading in the lower court, but the appellate court did not consider about this area of Article 54. Therefore, the appeal was set aside. Now, the following factors to be brought to our mind and keep it in instant freeze. Number one, how the appeal should be prepared. You have to say that the appellate court did not comply the provisions of Order 31, Order 41, Rule 31, and the guidelines of 96 CPC. The judgment also distinguishes the difference between second appeal under 100 CPC and section 96 first appeal. And you have to say if any substantial question of law or provision of law where you have a statutory difference, if not been discussed by the appellate court, you can also agitate that ground. Kindly go through this entirety of that. Then my humble persuasion that whatever may be, now the Bar Council has initiated the proceedings to help the poor advocates. I have some grievance, but still this is not the high time to discuss those grievances. If any large issue is being considered, there will be some here and there some mistakes. let us tolerate that. And I hope the advocates at those who are entitled for that compensation shows that several advocates are living below poverty line. This is my humble submission. The judiciary must keep it in mind and regulate so many areas wherein they always appoint their nepotism relatives as mediator, arbitrators, and lokadalat co-participant along with the judges. Therein, they are only sidelining the persons who are nearby and lobbied. So many things are happening. All these things in the near future also, they should keep in mind, they should act without any partial in mind. There should be regulation for appointment of those mediators and the lokadalat sitting members from the bar. Thank you. Best wishes.